Okay, family.
Okay. So, where was I? I love this song, so I have to replay it. This is my shit. I like Christina Aguilera. And this song is called Understand, and it is the business. It's on her Back to Basics album. Listen. Everybody but me, yeah, yeah. See, I've been hurt so many times before, and my hope was gone. So sick of crying. And then you came into my life, you opened up my softest side, yeah. This is the shit. So anyway, so he had met this chick on a chat line. And this was all mid-September. And all this stemmed from when I went out to the Hoodies in Vegas. And I think I was gone for about 5 days or something. And so anyway, he met this chick. And they ended up sleeping together that same night that I was telling you guys about the all that. So they slept together. And, you know, but my ESP kicks in so tough, you know what I'm saying? And like I was telling you ladies, you guys need to know what type of man you're dealing with, you know? And you gotta kinda be a little nosy sometimes. I mean, I do it too, you know what I mean? I do it too, you know? And sometimes, but you know what? But the thing is, what you're looking for, baby, you're gonna find it. So, you know, if you want to do some snooping and then some Inspector Gadget shit, you got to be, you know, hard shell to be able to, you know, handle what you're looking for. Because you're going to find exactly what you're looking for. If your mind is already telling you in the back of your mind, like, you know what? Something ain't up with him. He up to something. He is. And once again, when a person show you who they are, you're supposed to believe them. So, I'm telling you, so that hurt me yet once again, because I was like, you know, here, you know, I look all right, you know what I'm saying? When we go out to our little concerts and stuff, you know, I know how to, you know what I'm saying, fillet my shit all out and tuck them up and flip them up and put my hair on by the pound and, you know, put my lashes on. Shit, I'm the shit. He half a hundred. You know what I'm saying? I'm a dime. Shit. Fuck that. I'm one of them 50 cent pieces. I'm that silver dollar, the woman with the baby on the back. You know what I'm saying? Nigga, you lucky you got somebody like me. You know what I'm saying? And so all the time, you know, I'm fucking with his ego. And that's just not cool. You know what I mean? It's not cool. Whether it's here nor there, or if it's right or wrong, or whatever the case. Yet and still, you know, I've been wrong for that. But see, a lot of it stemmed from, I never thought he would do me one of them. I didn't think he had the capabilities of doing it. You know what I'm saying? I just didn't think. I underestimated him, okay? So, when he went back and done that again, and, no, I was doing good. I don't want to hear that right now. Let me get some Tyrone in shit. So anyway, so he did that September. And so that hurt me. I was like, wow. You know, so at that point in time, I just started, you know, a wedge just started coming between me a little bit. Because I'm like, okay, now I can't trust you. Because, you know, this has been our place. Though that is his place, but to me, theoretically, I felt like it was our place. You know what I mean? And though he says that he went over there to her house, which, you know, that's still, I mean, it don't matter. You did it. It don't matter. If you was over there, over here, whatever, you still did it. But, of course, you know, I goes to the source. fuck what you're going through. You know, I go to the source. And you know what, ladies? You know, don't get mad at the other woman. Don't get mad at the woman when she call you up and say, you know, I just got a couple questions for you. Woman to woman, you know. You know, I've been with such and such, and I just want to know, has he been seeing you on a sexual level? Some women go ballistic with it. Some of them be like, why don't you ask him? Bitch, why are you calling me? Ask him. I think that is so fucking stupid. You know what I'm saying? I feel like that is so fucking stupid, because you let somebody call me, please, and ask me about your motherfucking husband and watch me throw that nigga all the way up under the bus. Whereas his ass is holding on to the tailpipe and it done ran his foot over. You know what I'm saying? I'm going to put his ass out there so deep, knee deep. You let somebody call me and ask me, oh, well, do you know Melvin? I'm just going to give up all the tea on Melvin's ass and don't give a fuck about the consequences. Y'all already know how I get down, and it won't be nothing. What are you going to do? So, but anyway, the lady was real cool. She was nice. You know, she put it all out there. Oh, well, he came over here with some Bacardi and Coke and, yeah, and shit. And, I rolled up a blunt. Who says that? I mean, who says that? I mean, come on. So she was like, so, you know, of course I wouldn't disrespect the lady and nothing like that. But I'm saying to myself, okay, Ken. You know, I mean, like, for real? For real? You know what I mean? But that's what she said. She came out with, well, you know, I twisted one up and it went down and I sent his ass home and I went on to bed and it's what it was. But, you know, I don't want him. It was just something that happened. For real? I'm like, is people still, I mean, is women doing that nowadays? Because the thing is, I'm so blown by that because, shit, most of my adult life I spent married. You know, I mean, I didn't go out to a club until I went at 18. I think I went in the beginning of 19. But after that, I didn't go back to a club till I was about 33, 34 years old. So I don't, for my 20s, I was mommy wife. I don't know nothing about all that one night stand shit and all that other shit. I don't know nothing about it. Because I was kept. So, you know, to get out here into this dating scene and the shit, the bullshit that goes on and the lack of respect for women and that women have for themselves is just, it's horrible. I mean, it's just, it's horrible. I don't understand it. I can't wrap my head around it. I don't understand it. Because trust and believe, you know, and that's why I am the way that I am with my daughter, and I want her to have some self-worth, you know, and all that kinds of stuff, because, man, I mean, I just, I'm bewildered. But that wasn't the last time, okay? Now, he did that in September, but guess what, y'all? When I was going through, and my, you know, it was like a whirlwind going around in my head, guess what? He went back on there again, ladies, last month, November. But this chick came to our place over there. So it's like, okay, now you done me one again. For real, Kenny? Seriously? And what's so cold about it, both of them was like, it was just something to do. And then what's so cold is this chick, let me tell you how cold this bitch was. Now, I won't call her no, but y'all know I say bitch real loosely, so don't take it personal. But this chick come with, I was supposed to have got up with him, but I went to court and went to jail and, you know, and I'm like, huh? I mean, who says that? So she was giving me the whole get up on, she had just went to jail and this, that, and the other. And I'm like, wow. I looked at him, y'all, let me tell you something. And And I'm sitting at his house, right? We're sitting at the table. You know, of course, I'm calling the chick up because now I really can't trust nothing at what you're talking about. Whatever you're talking about is boo-boo to me. You know, so it's like, okay, go ahead on, give me your phone. And ladies, I don't advise this for nobody because it's juvenile. But when a woman is hurting, she go to different lengths. And I'll be the first one to say, you know what? I was hurt like a motherfucker. Hurt. Because here, it's like, okay, I accepted this motherfucker back yet again. And he goes and he does this yet again. You know what I mean? And that, I was blown. And so she was like, at first she didn't even want to come out with they did that. She was like, oh, no. You know, I was selling some weed and, you know, and this and that and the other, and it was a transaction type of thing. That's what she told me. He one came out with, well, baby, I'm sorry. Yeah, I'm going to admit with, because she never told me that. She not one time told me that. He told me that. All right, baby. Oh, he was snotting and crying and cutting up and begging and grabbing. And y'all, let me tell you something. Let me tell you what I did, y'all. He was sitting at the table. We sitting up here talking and everything. And y'all, let me tell you something. He had a 22-ounce bottle of beer or whatever that he was drinking or whatever. And he talking, it's all like he's biting at the wind. Like, you know, I'm like, you know, it was like, I went in the zone. I went some other place. Baby, I picked up that motherfucking bottle and just, pow, hit his ass. Yeah. A few weeks ago, I hit that motherfucker upside the head with a bottle. Yes, I did that. I'll be the first one to say it. I did that. I cracked his head with that motherfucking bottle so goddamn quick. Before I can even think. Because I was so fucking hurt. It's like, for real, you did be one of them? And, you know, and I had to, it was like a quiet before the storm because I just got real calm. But I was in such a fucking zone. I don't remember when I grabbed it. I don't know nothing. All I know is I just picked it up and I went, bop. Yes. So, at that point in time, I was like, you know what, nigga, fuck you and all the rest of the shit that you involved with, I'm cool. You mix max motherfucker. I mean, I was all that. Let me tell you something. I showed out so tough because see here, all this time I never show out. I never cut up, clown, nothing. I be real cool, kind, collected, and all that kind of shit. But I had to go and let him know that I'm low key 5150, and I had to let him know. Let me tell you something, motherfucker. Okay, because apparently you take my little kindness for weakness. So let me show you that this is not a game. And I tied one on. So let me check this time right quick. I don't even need to say nothing. Y'all already know what time it is. All right. In a minute.